The most famous reindeer of all.
Charles.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny.
Hi everyone, my name is Mridul and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my reception look. So I'm going to be sharing with you guys details of how I made this outfit. This is an outfit from scratch. Other than that, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my makeup also. I don't think this makeup look is very different or unique, but I have picked up like a few tips and tricks along the way wherein I learned how to make my makeup look better on like hectic long days. Because as you might or might not know, my very very close friends got married very recently and I had to wear makeup for like 4 days in a row for literally like 12-13 days an hour. So I picked up a lot of different things and tips, so I wanted to share that with you guys in today's video. I think let's get started with the makeup. I'm gonna break down how I created this look right here. I'm gonna be sharing with you guys all the details. All the products are obviously gonna be linked down below as well. So let's get started with today's video. Okay, so let's get started. Now before I start using my skincare to prep my skin, the first step that I've been doing recently is that I've been icing my face. Now this is a tip that was given to me by Adya's makeup and hairstylist, who also did my hair by the way, and she killed it. So as you can see, I have been breaking out quite a lot. It's actually a lot better than it was during like all the events and then the functions. It's gotten much better now, but it was very very bad and I was having a really tough time applying my makeup. So she told me that you should ice your face for like 5 to 7 minutes before you start doing your makeup, and it helped me tremendously. My makeup laid so well and it looked so beautiful, and icing obviously kind of flattens out your bumps just temporarily, not for long. But in that meanwhile, you can like do your application and it works really well. So this is one tip that I wanted to give you guys. I'm done with icing my face. Now we're gonna get started with prep. Skin prep is so important. I've said this so many times here on my channel. Now today I'm gonna be using products from Aqualogica. I've already used their face wash. So this is the Hydrate Plus face wash. This has coconut water and hyaluronic acid in it. Next, I'm gonna go in with this serum. So this is the Aqualogica's Hydrate Plus serum. Now this serum has clinically proven to increase hydration by 83%. What I really like about Aqualogica is that they've made skincare for Indian skin and Indian climate. Now there are lots of like creams and serums available in the Indian market, but most of them are very greasy and very oily, and most of them just work on the top layer of your skin, whereas these products penetrate deep into your skin and provide you hydration for hours. My skin feels so hydrated from within and it's not sticky, which is very important. I don't think I need to talk about the glow because you guys can see it for yourself. To top it up, I'm gonna go in with the Aqualogica's Hydrate Plus Gel Moisturizer. The gel moisturizer is clinically proven to increase hydration by 74%. One thing that I really love about Aqualogica is that they have committed to provide access to clean drinking water to those in need, and this will be done through every purchase that is made on their website. So they also have a sleeping mask, which is something that you can use at night. Now in case you want to check these products out for yourself, you can get them on Nykaa or even on aqualogica.in. If you use my code MRIDUL20, you'll get a flat 20% off on aqualogica.in. So now that my skin is feeling plump and prep for makeup, I'm gonna start off with foundation, and this is the foundation that I've used for all the main like events, and I have to say this literally saved my skin. Nothing was looking good on my skin because of the number of like pimples that I had and so much redness that I had, but this foundation just made everything look so beautiful and so flawless. So I will definitely recommend you guys checking this out. This is the Estee Lauder's Double Wear Stay in Place Foundation. Obviously it is pricey, I'm not denying that, which is why I ended up picking up like a mini, because I was also not sure if I wanted to like invest in such an expensive foundation. Thankfully it ended up being totally worth it. Now for today, I'm gonna be again using the Simba Lifestyles 8 brush set, because I was in a hurry that day also and I ended up using the 8 brush set, so makes sense for me to use that today also. Now one thing that I learned was that using little bit of foundation goes a very long way, especially when you're breaking out. Like pehle mera mentality aisa tha ki I'm going to cake up my face because I'm so insecure about my skin, I want to put lots and lots of foundation to hide everything. But you can hide your redness, you can hide the discoloration, you can't hide the bumps. So very little goes a long way, because then it's not going to stick on your pimples and it's not going to look cakey then. So I go in with very, very little at a time. Agar baad mein zarurat padi, so we can always add it in. So foundation brush se main apply karti hu, and then I just buff it in. Absolutely never forget your neck. Then I will be going in with a beauty sponge. I usually don't go in with a beauty sponge, but because my skin has lots of bumps, I want to kind of run my beauty blender through it so that it picks up all the extra product jo uske aaju baaju laga hua hai. Because I don't want my face to look cakey, right? So just doing this one extra step to prevent that. So for concealer, I did two concealers. The first one being the classic LA Girl concealer in the inner corners. And then I would do the Swiss Beauty concealer because it's a little bit lighter on me. I like it underneath my eyes just to brighten it up. By the way, the Swiss Beauty concealer on its own also is so amazing. Like the coverage on that is out of the world. Putting a little bit extra on my upper lip also because of my burn. If you've seen my last Get Ready With Me, you would know what happened to my upper lip. Time to set everything in place. I'm going in with the Charlotte Tilbury powder. Again, a very expensive product, but it's so, so good. This is all I've used in like every event. And I'm going to be using this small little blending brush in order to apply this. This is an eye brush, like eyeshadow brush, but I like to use this to set my under eyes because I can like really go in and make sure that there is no creasing at all. Going in with the big fluffy brush and picking up these two shades. These are from the K by Katrina Genius Pro Contour. I think that's what it's called. And I just like went crazy. So that day on the reception day, I had no time to get ready. So this is what I did just to bronze up my face. I highly recommend this product because if you're someone who doesn't know how to like figure out your shade online for like a contour powder, because that is me also. I have bought so many powders and they just don't match on me. They're too cool, too warm. This is perfect because this has cool tones also, warm tones also, and you can mix and match. Like you can mix like how I mix these two. You can mix these two or you can mix whatever and make like a custom shade for you, and it works. I really like this powder. Quickly going to highlight with another Charlotte Tilbury product. I do have another product, like an affordable dupe for you guys that you can use. This is the Lakme's Absolute Liquid Highlighter. This is something that I used on my body also, and it's so pretty, very, very pretty. I really like the rose gold shade, but I'm going to use this because that's what I used on that specific day. I personally don't like too much like glitter on my face. Like I want it to look natural as it can. I prefer blending this with my fingers. I just think that's how it works the best personally. Do you see what I'm talking about? It's so beautiful. I've gone back to my favorite product. This used to be like my ride or die back in the day. This is the Nykaa's Brow Pencil. And I've gone back to this because it's very quick. Like usually I do really enjoy like sitting there and like carving out my brows. But when you don't have the time, this is a really, really good product because the stick on this is thick and it just helps you shape your brows really well. It also comes with a spoolie, so you don't have to dig around for another spoolie. Taking another blending brush and then the same K by Katrina contour powder, I'm just going to dust a little bit in the crease of my eye. I think I'm going to do these two shades. For my wings, this is the eyeliner that I use. This is the Nykaa's 24-hour Luxe eyeliner. Now this comes with a very stiff brush. It doesn't have like a paint brush sort of a situation. It has a stiff brush, which I actually like. It's very comfortable to make wings. You definitely get way more control with this kind of brush applicator. I completely forgot to put some eyeshadow on the bottom of my lashes, so I'm going in with this pencil brush and then the same two shades that we used and just kind of adding a little bit of something. I'm gonna pop on some lashes. So the lashes that I used throughout the all like the events was Samantha, the style Samantha from Huda Beauty. Now these lashes will last you forever, and I specifically kept those lashes aside for all of these events. I started using them on
Sangeet Day, I use them for the Shadi also, the reception also, and I can still definitely use them like 20 more times. So I really recommend those lashes. They look very beautiful and I got lots of compliments on those lashes specifically. This is the lash glue that I use. This is from PAC. This specific one I really like over the black one that it comes in. Very, very foolproof and it will not budge. There were lots of tears shed and my lashes did not move. So I will give this a huge thumbs up. So while my lashes are drying, I'm going to quickly show you the lip combination that I used on the day. I started off with this Nykaa lipstick. This is in the shade Mumtaz. It's a very pretty, like a chili red almost. Very electric red. So I did that. Now I use this as my first layer. And it also comes with a very like nice sharp applicator, which is very handy to like line your lips. So that's what I'm doing. So it's a very pretty red, as you can see, but it's a lot. Like it's really, really a lot. So I wanted to go in with my all-time favorite red, which is from Verified. And this is in the shade BBRL. It's a beautiful red. On its own also, it's very pretty. But I wanted to layer my reds because of the same logic. Because I personally believe ki zyada lipsticks lagate to lips zyada plump lagte hai and zyada long last bhi hota hai. Iske liye I wanted to do at least two lipsticks. So this is what I'm going to layer on top. And this is what is going to give me that beautiful red lip, like the classic red. I could have worn this on its own also. It's very pretty, but this does not last long at all. Whereas this you can wear on its own. But the combination of these two was perfect. I had to like apply my lipstick, I think like once after I was done eating, which is fine. You know, I didn't have to like sit there and apply it every time before I was taking pictures or whatever. So I approve of these two combinations. To finish my eye, I have to use a mascara. I absolutely cannot finish any look without some inner corner highlight. And I'm just going to quickly do that using this brush, which I specially made for me to be able to use my inner corner highlight. I use this on the tip of my nose also.
And yeah, this is what the makeup looks like. I personally really, really love the way it looks. It's very in my comfort zone, I will say that. Now let's move on to the outfit. Now before I move on to the outfit, let me quickly share with you guys the mood board that I had created for this very outfit. As I mentioned earlier, this outfit is very in my comfort zone. This was the only outfit that I felt extremely comfortable in and very me in. Like I love the color white, I love chicken curry, and I love this very like makeup look. This makeup look is like my go-to. So I was very like in my element. So talking about the outfit, I really wanted to make a chicken curry outfit, like a full white lehenga outfit. So my first stop was to go to Elle Peri, which is in Andheri. In total, I picked up 9 meters of kapda, 9 meters of chicken curry kapda, and 1 meter was for 8.95 rupees. So it's very, very expensive. This is real chicken curry slash Lakhnavi, one or the other. So this kind of kapda is very expensive, which is why by the end of it, my entire kapda was for 8,000 rupees, which is a lot of money. And then I had to pay 2,000 rupees to my tailor who stitched this. So she stitched the lehenga, she stitched the blouse, the dupatta, and also a cute little bag to go along with it, a portly bag. So in total, my entire outfit costed me 10,000 rupees, under 10,000 rupees, which is actually really, really good for a lehenga. Without any further ado, let me just show you what the full outfit looks like.
Okay, so this is what my white lehenga looks like. Now for the actual lehenga, I did get lots of can-can added because I wanted my lehenga to be poofy. And talking about the blouse, it's a full sleeves blouse with a square neckline. I do also have a dupatta, very, very simple. I haven't gotten anything added to the dupatta. And then here's the little portly, very, very cute. It's made out of the same material. The back of the blouse is very similar. It's the same square that is in the front as well. As for the accessories, I actually kept it very, very simple. I just went with these silver jhumkas, which I believe are from the VP store. They're very, very pretty and I think they complement my outfit really well. And other than that, I was wearing a small little bindi, a diamond bindi. Those are the only two things that I was wearing. Another close-up of my portly. It's such a cute portly. I also got these like tassels added to the end. I think those add a lot. But overall, I think it's such a classy outfit. I think you should also get a white lehenga stitched for your upcoming wedding. It's very, very classy, very versatile, so chic. And you can definitely style it in a lot of different ways individually. Like each piece you can style individually.
And yeah, that's it for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching today's video, and I'll see you soon in my next one. Bye.